Philippine Mobile Wallet Service, GCash, saying it's addressing incidents of unauthorized money transfers from its users' accounts. This followed complaints on social media by GCash users who said they lost certain amounts from transfers that they did not make. The fintech firm in a statement said some users were indeed affected by an ongoing system reconciliation process. It maintained it's an isolated incident and assured users their accounts are safe. GCash also saying wallet adjustments are underway after it identified the affected accounts. A network of digital advocates has since urged the ICT department to probe the incident. Digital Pinoy's called it alarming for consumers who entrusted their funds to e-wallet providers. It also urged GCash to return the lost funds to users immediately. The Philippine government and retailers expect the cost of Christmas food items to remain stable. In fact, this holiday season, that's good news for Filipino households hoping to catch a break amid rising food prices. Andrea Taguinas tells us more.
A Christmas feast that won't break the bank? The Philippine Retailers Association said that's possible this holiday season, as it does not expect any spike in the prices of Noche Buena items or food usually served during Christmas. The Department of Trade and Industry also echoed this.
We've gone through a soft landing on inflation. Most Christmas goodies, mga ginagamit for mga handaan for Christmas, are all within the price range established by the DTI. No unexpected surprises or price spikes that will go up to the end of the year.
There's no price increase, yeah, for this Christmas.
Claudio said even the recent depreciation of the peso won't be a problem, at least in the short term.
Ngayon lang naman nag-spike yung dollar. So since they have already brought in the, there's very little importation to be done up to the end of the year. That will require a higher exchange rate.
With inflation less of a concern, the PRA is also banking on increased purchasing power to boost sales. For its part, the Supply Chain Management Association of the Philippines said logistics services have made the necessary preparations to ensure the timely delivery of goods this shopping season.
We are preparing additional resources. We even book shipping lines ahead of time just to make sure that we reach the islands as well. Customer service and sales usually talk to the retailers ahead of time to book the orders ahead so we can deliver, especially for those included in the Christmas baskets.
The DTI got together with logistics players and retailers on Friday for the signing of a memorandum of understanding on the crafting of a blueprint for the wholesale and retail trade sector. The blueprint aims to balance digitalization efforts to improve business operations and lower logistics costs, and still being able to retain and create jobs for people.
Kasi once the delivery or once the logistics cost is high, it's hard for us to be able to sell and to be able to move the products.
One of the big costs kasi of logistics is actually the warehousing, the manpower side. If we upscale together with digitalization our supply chain talents, we might have faster deliveries, faster operations.
For the PRA, market access initiatives enhancing the presence and competitiveness of Filipino products are also important.
Kasi hindi makakompete yung mga Philippine products in the foreign marketplaces. Eh. Kasi they're all flooded with Chinese or foreign products. So Philippine-made products suffer in terms of pricing or selection.
Also part of the plan is the staging of the very first wholesale and retail trade forum next year. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Malacanang orders the Cagayan Special Economic Zone Authority to implement President Marcos's POGO ban. CESA Administrator Katrina Ponce Enrile previously insisted no POGOs were operating within the ECO zone. But she admitted to allowing interactive gaming operations. But under the President's order, the ban will include internet gaming and other similar operations. This will take effect next month. Filipino consumers can expect cheaper rice next week after the Agriculture Department reached an agreement with market leaders to cap profits on the staple food. Jervis Manahan with details.
The Department of Agriculture has reached an agreement with rice retailers to reduce rice prices in Metro Manila on Friday. The deal aims to limit the profit margin for well-milled and regular milled rice to 3 to 5 pesos per kilo. And with a 38 peso per kilo farm gate price, this means rice should be sold at around 43 pesos per kilo starting next week.
So with this agreement kanina, we're hoping na talaga ma-sustain na hindi lang siya pili, kundi talagang ito yung magiging standard na pag regular at well-milled, talagang dapat hindi tataas ng 45 ang presyuhan dapat sa palengke.
This agreement takes effect next week. Agriculture officials say they will go around markets to check if retailers will follow. They admit, however, no sanctions will be imposed for those who will not adhere to the agreement.
Yun ay agreement at umaasa kami na talagang susunod sila. Titingnan din namin kasama sa meeting, of course, kanina ang enforcement at saka ang aming implementation team, pangunan ni ASIC Itos. Part din, titingnan kung merong probability ng profiteering o kung ano man.
Rice retailers maintain they have long been keeping their profit margin at the 3 to 5 pesos range ever since. They say the problem stems from high prices from suppliers, which makes it practically impossible to further bring down rice prices below the 43 pesos per kilo level.
Mga dating magaganda talaga, hindi naman nagbabago ang presyo niyan. Medyo umaangat nga ng konti eh. Dahil sa tumal, bumababa. Pero yung quality naman, mababa nga, hindi naman maganda.
The initiative is government's latest effort to make the staple grain more affordable. In September 2023, government imposed a price cap on rice, but quickly lifted it after just 1 month. Tariff cuts on rice importation, which are expected to reduce rice prices, have yet to be felt by the public. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Now, bad news for motorists. Another major oil price hike looms next week. Diesel prices could rise by over 2 pesos per liter, while gasoline and kerosene may see price increases of at least 1 peso and 20 centavos per liter. The Energy Department has cited the ongoing hurricane season in the U.S. and the OPEC Plus's decision to delay plans to increase production as key factors contributing to the expected big-time price hike. Another province devastated by Typhoon Marce is Ilocos Norte. The town of Pagudpud has already declared a state of calamity after the storm destroyed homes, roads, and crops. Residents in coastal villages were also forced to evacuate. The local government says they are still assessing the damage to the affected areas. The agriculture sector in the province of Isabela has lost nearly half a billion pesos now due to damage caused by consecutive typhoons. The Department of Agriculture says the cost of damage could further rise as it collects more data from different towns. According to one official, they don't expect rice supply to be significantly affected since most rice fields only suffered partial damage. The president is expected to visit the province next week to distribute aid to the affected residents. Typhoon Marce caused widespread damage in Cagayan Province with strong winds tearing off roofs and uprooting trees. In the coastal town of Gonzaga, infrastructure damage was estimated at 23 million pesos. The northern parts of the province were also left without power. The local disaster management office is appealing for assistance in rehabilitation efforts, as well as the urgent replenishment of their quick response funds.
We don't actually need yung mga food items ngayon because the DSWD
meron, completo.
May stockpile po ang probinsya, may stockpile yung local government, pati yung barangay po.
Mm-mm.
What we need now is the rehabilitation note ng ating mga kababayan. Panahon po ni Julian, we placed the province under state of calamity at nag-appropriate tayo mula doon sa quick response fund natin. Pagdating po ni Christine, another appropriation from the quick response fund, and that has already been depleted.
Ayun.
So nagpabot po tayo sa Office of Civil Defense for the replenishment of the quick response fund po nung dumating si Leon and ito si Marcy and there's another weather inclement na.
Now, residents of the Philippine city of Tacloban marked the 11th year since it suffered the brunt of Super Typhoon Yolanda. Survivors of the storm offered a mass at the Yolanda Memorial Mass Grave, where over 2,000 victims are buried. Tacloban City Mayor Alfred Romualdez emphasized the importance of disaster preparedness and the looming threat of climate change. Yolanda is considered the deadliest typhoon to hit the Philippines. Over 6,000 people were killed by that storm. President Marcos calls for a stronger response to climate change as the country marks the 11th anniversary of the Super Typhoon Yolanda disaster. In a statement, the president said the impact of recent storms should remind Filipinos of powerful lessons from the strongest typhoon in the world. He also emphasized the need to empower communities and strengthen local government units in responding to these calamities. Mr. Marcos thanked the international community and the various organizations who helped the victims of Super Typhoon Yolanda, internationally known as Haiyan. The United States voices support for the Philippines' newly enacted Maritime Zones Act. In a statement, the U.S. State Department called the law an important step in clarifying the country's maritime territories. It also praised Manila for upholding international law and aligning its maritime zones with the 1982 Law of the Sea Convention. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Friday signed a measure that defines the Philippines' rights as an archipelagic state to safeguard its maritime resources. It also signed the Archipelagic Sea Lanes Act, which will designate sea lanes and air routes for foreign vessels as well as aircraft. A geopolitical analyst says the Philippines should further boost its engagement with the United States and its allies to strengthen the country's claims in the West Philippine Sea. De La Salle University Professor Don McLean Hill believes enhanced ties will help ensure the effective enforcement of the twin maritime laws aimed at protecting Manila's interests in the West Philippine Sea. Now, he also believes there will be no radical changes in the country's alliance with the U.S. under a Trump presidency. Hill, however, maintains the Philippine government should be consistent in reminding the Trump administration that the stability of the Indo-Pacific region is in the best interest of the United States.